The single responsibility principle is probably the most valuable guide we use when striving for simplicity in the design. But it doesn't turn out too well every time. Oftentimes, a class must also implement a few other things that support its single responsibility. Implementing these separate concerns will make the class complicated and convoluted again, even though it was meant to be simple. How do we remove separate concerns from a class without losing its functionality? That I plan to show you on an interesting class which is currently suffering from that very problem. We will start from this interface. It is declaring discounts. There are several implementations of this interface in the codebase. And discount applies to a price producing 0, 1 or multiple lines specifying how much money should be deducted from the price. And this is the important implementation of that interface, the class in which we will spend most of this demo. It is implementing the composite design pattern. And I have serious complaints about the complexity of this class. What is this class doing? As any composite implementation, it is wrapping around multiple other instances implementing that same interface. So it's managing the state, and then it manages behavior. It is combining the results produced by multiple other objects into a single unified result. That is how composite pattern operates. That is 4 lines of meaningful code. And the remaining, 30 lines of code is plumbing. This line of code is the reason for so much plumbing. When multiple discounts are applied in parallel, they don't know about each other. The problem is that the sum of all the discounts produced in this way could be greater than the original price. The shop would be paying to its customers to take the goods away. We must solve that problem somehow. So, to ensure that the sum of all the discounts is never greater than the price from which we have started, I have introduced a factory method. The constructor is private, and the only way to construct an object of this composite implementation is through this factory method. It creates the parallel discounts composite instance, but then wraps it into a decorator which caps the sum of all discounts to 100% of the original price. If you want to learn more about how this composition works, how composite and the decorator pattern works together, please watch the previous video where I have explained that. Right here we have a different problem to solve. The complexity of this composite implementation. That idea to wrap a composite object into a decorator object led to a performance optimization. If there are no discounts to wrap, then create nothing, just return the null object implementation. If there is only one discount, there is no reason to wrap it into anything, just return that discount, and it will manage, of course. There was more when optimizing execution. Why not flatten the parallel discounts? We should pull their contained discounts up. And why stop there with optimizations? This purge method is removing null object implementations from the sequence before wrapping them into the parallel discounts composite object. That is a lot of work, a lot of logic here to support that single line of code. You see, that is how complexity sneaks into your classes. And I want that complexity out. These 4 static methods I consider separate concerns. You may have heard about separation of concerns at architectural level or high design level, but that problem exists at the level of classes and level of methods as well. Whenever a class must do something else to support its own concern, I think that should also be called a separate concern in that class. So I want these static methods out of this class. Mind you, these methods are static. For a reason, they will never change. There will be no variation in these operations. They will always be the same, but they must execute before this class takes over. And so the implementation of those operations will remain static, but where? This purge method is universal. It is not related to parallel discounts in isolation. It can apply to any other sequence of discounts as well. So I will create a new class, but look where, in the namespace where the iDiscount interface is declared, I will put this operation there in that namespace. It would be a separate concern to all other classes that need it. The method would remove null object instances. So back at the composite implementation, we can use this new method here and delete the method below. And what about this method, flattening out parallel discounts? Well, it is specific to parallel discounts only, so I will define a new class for extension methods in the same namespace where the parallel discounts class is implemented. I will add that same method here, change its name. You see, the name of the method must be more specific now to indicate that it is only flattening parallel discounts. But now we have a compile time error. Extension methods require access to components of the class to which they apply. The state will still be encapsulated. Look here, I will turn this property public, but the internal state is still encapsulated because there is no setter and this getter. You don't know if it is returning the internal state or calculating it somehow. The encapsulation is not jeopardized by this operation. So in the end, I was able to remove another chunk of logic from this class, turn it into a separate implementation elsewhere, and look, use it here as an external service implemented somewhere else, so that eventually I can delete the entire utility method below. The largest method in this class is just gone. Don't be afraid of letting others access the state or this property getter, which has become public. You would do the same thing if you needed to test this class in isolation. You would also need access to the components of the resulting object if you wanted to inspect it. But before we continue, let me ask you for a favor. Please press the like button now. That will help me promote this video. Thank you. And if you wish to download the source code of this demo, the source code is available to sponsors of my channel. You can follow the link from the description to my Patreon page, become the sponsor, and download the source code from this demo and all other videos on this channel. I'm grateful to everyone who is supporting my channel for sponsorship. I really am. Thank you very much for that. A larger issue is only ahead, and let me show you where the things become complicated if you want to remove all separate concerns from the class. I wonder if I could also remove creation as well. That logic is sensitive, and that is the reason why the constructor above is private. I don't want anyone to construct this object without wrapping it into the decorator. But now I have two opposing forces, and I must choose. Either make the constructor accessible from the outside and remove these create methods from this class and put it somewhere else, or leave the things as they are. So you can choose to stop here. The class is already much better. The most complicated portions of logic have already been moved to extension methods, and we could stop here. Or we could choose to go on and really make this class only implement a single responsibility and nothing else, which means not even contain the construction logic. If you want to go down that path, then let me show you how you can do that. I might choose to make the constructor public, but maybe not. We can also make it internal, so that it is only accessible from inside this assembly. It is easing my conscience, to be honest. There must be a convention or static code analysis or any other method that will guarantee that nobody ever calls this constructor directly, but only through the factory method which I'm just about to declare. I will move where other general operators are and define an operator called asParallel. These depend on the internal constructor in the same assembly, so technically this is fine. But again, there is the problem that somebody else from this same assembly might call the constructor directly without knowing that every instance must be wrapped into a decorator to be correct. But then, with this factory method implemented elsewhere, we can delete the static factories from here. I'm not entirely happy with the final step I made here, but look at the class now. This class has a single responsibility it implements. Contain multiple discounts, so to combine the results of applying those multiple discounts to the single price and aggregating their results into a single unified result. That is the single responsibility of the composite implementation. Compare this class to what we had at the beginning. It is 3, 4, 5 times shorter than it was. All concerns have been removed, except that one. That is what I wanted to show you. If you have a class which has suddenly exploded in functionalities that are only supporting and also are required to support that single responsibility of the class, and you don't like it that way, this is the way how you can help yourself, how you can pull those separate concerns out into other classes, organize them, put them where they belong, and just call them from inside the class, making 1 or 2 trivial method calls within that implementation of the single responsibility, and your class will have only a few lines of code left again. I hope you have learned a valuable technique from this demo and that you will try it out on your code. See you in the next episode.